Freedom. Wow. Everybody wants it. I sure as heck want it. Freedom from grief, from pain, from suffering, from lack, from all the ills that flesh is heir to, as it says, right? So I delved into the pastor, and this is what I found out about freedom. Exodus. And God spake all these words, saying, I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Thou shalt have no other gods before me. And God spake unto Moses and said unto him, I am the Lord. And I appeared unto Abraham, unto Isaac, and unto Jacob by the name of God Almighty. But by my name Jehovah was I not known to them. And I have also heard the groaning of the children of Israel, whom the Egyptians keep in bondage, and I have remembered my covenant. Wherefore, say unto the children of Israel, I am the Lord, and I will bring you out from under the burdens of the Egyptians, and I will rid you out of their bondage. And I will take you to me for a people, and I will be to you a God, and ye shall know that I am the Lord your God, which bringeth you out from under the burdens of the Egyptians. And Moses said unto the people, Remember this day in which ye came out from Egypt, out of the house of bondage. For by strength of hand the Lord brought you out from this place. And it shall be when thy son asketh thee in time to come, saying, What is this? Thou shalt say unto him, By the strength of hand the Lord brought us out from Egypt, from the house of bondage. Psalms. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doth he meditate day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. John. Then said Jesus to those Jews which believed on him, Ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. They answered him, We be Abraham's seed, and were never in bondage to any man. How sayest thou, Ye shall be made free? Jesus answered them, Verily, verily, I say unto you, whosoever committeth sin is the servant of sin. If the Son therefore shall make you free, ye shall be free indeed. Romans. There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus hath made me free from the law of sin and death. For you have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but you have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ. Galatians, stand fast, therefore, in the liberty wherewith Christ hath made us free, and be not entangled again with the yoke of bondage. And correlative passages from our textbook. There is no power apart from God. Omnipotence has all power. And to acknowledge any other power is to dishonor God. Mind is not necessarily dependent upon educational processes. It possesses of itself all beauty and poetry and the power of expressing them. Spirit, God, is heard when the senses are silent. The influence or action of soul confers our freedom. There is moral freedom in soul. God has built a higher platform of human rights, and he has built it on diviner claims. These claims are not made through code or creed, but in demonstration of on earth peace, goodwill toward men. Human codes, scholastic theology, material medicine, and hygiene, fetter faith, and spiritual understanding. Divine science rends asunder these fetters, and man's birthright of soul, allegiance to his maker, asserts itself. Discerning the rights of man, we cannot fail to foresee the doom of all oppression. Slavery is not the legitimate state of man. God made man free. Paul said, I was freeborn. All men should be free. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Love and truth make free, but evil and error lead into captivity. Christian science raises the standard of liberty and cries, follow me. Escape from the bondage of sickness, sin, and death. Jesus marked out the way. Citizens of the world, accept the glorious liberty of the children of God and be free. This is your divine right. The enslavement of man is not legitimate. It will cease when man enters into his heritage of freedom, his God-given dominion over the material senses. Legally, to abolish unpaid servitude in the United States was hard, but the abolition of mental slavery is a more difficult task. Men and women of all climes and races are still in bondage to material sense, ignorant how to obtain their freedom. The voice of God on behalf of the African slave was still echoing in our land when the voice of the herald of this new crusade sounded the keynote of universal freedom, asking a fuller acknowledgement of the rights of man as a son of God, demanding that the fetters of sin, sickness, and death be stricken from the human mind, and that its freedom be won. Not through human warfare, not with bayonet and blood, but through Christ's divine science. I saw before me the sick, wearing out years of servitude to an unreal master, in the belief that the body governed them, rather than mind. The lame, the deaf, the dumb, the blind, the sick, the sensual, the sinner, I wish to save from the slavery of their own beliefs and from the educational systems of the pharaohs, who today as of yore hold the children of Israel in bondage. I saw before me the awful conflict, the Red Sea and the wilderness, but I pressed on through faith in God, trusting truth, the strong deliverer, to guide me into the land of Christian science, where fetters fall and the rights of man are fully known and acknowledged. I saw that the law of mortal belief includes all error, and that even as oppressive laws are disputed and mortals are taught their right to freedom, so the claims of the enslaving senses must be denied and superseded. The law of the divine mind must end human bondage, or mortals will continue unaware of man's inalienable rights and in subjection to hopeless slavery. Denial of the claims of matter is a great step towards the joys of spirit, towards human freedom. Mortals will someday assert their freedom in the name of Almighty God. Then they will control their own bodies through the understanding of divine science, dropping their pleasant beliefs, they will recognize harmony as the spiritual reality and discord as the material unreality. Love inspires, illumines, designates, and leads the way. Right motives give pinions to thought and strengthen freedom to speech and action. God's being is infinity, freedom, harmony, and boundless bliss. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty.